Minister, when President Chirac was here, even then we had discussed civilian nuclear exchange of nuclear technology from France to India. You are the leading manufacturer of that kind of nuclear energy. What are the obstacles?
We are determined to support the development of civilian nuclear technology in India through appropriate cooperation. The needs for energy in India are considerable. French capabilities in this field are first class and very secure, as far as our international commitments will allow us in this field of cooperation.
Qu'est-ce que peut faire l'Inde pour faciliter ces avancées?
So what can India do to allow and make these steps forward easier? First, it can show its sense of responsibility as a power.
Il est clair que la signature par l'Inde du CTBT faciliterait les choses.
And it's obvious that the signing by India of the CTBT would make things easier. And things would also be made easier if India accepted increased controls by the IAEA.
What are you saying which is different from what the Americans are saying or your other European partners are saying?
Je crois que nous disons plus franchement les choses.
I think we're probably franker. I think this was shown during the international reaction after the test. We were responsible and sensible in our reaction to India. And from the very beginning, France said that reacting by using sanction was not the appropriate means. I can't say we were delighted by this new situation, but we had to react it and face it sensibly. I can say that we feel today that the sanctions that had been imposed against our will, specifically sanctions in the international financial institutions, have no reason to remain.
Minister, the government of India included, in fact, the government of India led a debate, a national debate was launched to create a consensus on the signing of the CTBT and everything else that followed. This debate was started, it was engaged, then a series of mishaps took place, and that discussion has to be continued and possibly in Parliament. Until then, no cooperation?
There already is a cooperation in the field of safety, as I said earlier.
Je me réjouis du débat dont vous parlez.
And I welcome this debate that you are now mentioning. It's only normal for a great democratic state that such sensitive issues should be debated. And we do hope that you will reach the right conclusion for the benefit of our future cooperation. You will be deciding, and we will respect the choices you make.
Tell me, India signs the CTBT. What do you envisage will be India's status within the non-proliferation treaty?
I think the treaty is as it stands. It includes Article 9, which described the situation when the treaty was signed. But that doesn't mean that we can't take, in a sensible manner, in account of this new situation that has been created.
What you're saying is de facto nuclear power, but not de jure nuclear weapons power.
The terms, the provisions of the treaty can't be changed.
Can you persuade the nuclear club to open up all the facilities that India would then require?
I think it's a more comprehensive process. First, it has to be said that other nuclear powers don't react quite in the same way to this new situation. So this new situation for India in tomorrow's world, a world where we feel multipolarity should prevail, still has to be established and defined.
Talking of multipolarity, you have raised a hornet's nest as far as multipolarity, a multipolar world is concerned. You have caught the bull by the horns, as it were. What exactly is your vision of a multipolar world?
We realize that after the end of the Cold War, which was a bipolar world, we experience today a unipolar world, be it in the field of politics, diplomacy, economy, or culture. And this is a situation which is much too imbalanced compared to things as they really are in the richness of the world. Even some experts in the US say that this situation is a bit of an abusive situation and that things should be rebalanced. This has to be done in fair interaction with the multilateral system, I mean by that the other players involved in the UN, and the hinge between the two aspects has to be the United Nations Security Council, a Security Council which would be reformed and expanded.
You have, and you obviously have India as one of the permanent members of the Security Council, I take it.
I think that is obvious from our point of view. Today's world needs a central body for regulation, the body is set up by the Charter. But the Council is not representative enough anymore of today's world, and it won't be representative enough if we just add two countries from the Northern Hemisphere. So we feel India has a rightful place in this reformed Security Council.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.